Jesus. What sort of Jesus are we talking about, who actually finds people as they are and leaves them as they are? Apparently, prayer and fasting is supposed to be an answer to all problems in life. Well, I beg to differ that good work, hard work, diligence, education, all coming together to address the issues of poverty can be solutions in themselves. And that prayer is not a solution to everything. Please, go to school, don't pray. Pray that you pass exams. Go to work, don't pray. Prayer does not answer poverty. Poverty is an economic problem. Not only is it a spiritual inclination, but it's an economic problem. If you don't have an economic formula to turn around your economics, prayer cannot help you. Hence, Jesus gives us parables of the sower, learning how to sow. The parables of the people who were given talents and how to multiply your talents. The stories in the Old Testament of a woman whose husband had died and left the woman in debt and says, no, collect jars, fill up the jars, sell the oil, pay the debts, and etc. He didn't say pray for your debt to go off. And many of us as Christians, particularly my Adventist friends, please don't get confused and overexcited about the issues of prayer and your exclusion from political injustices in the society, and you think that your recitation of memory text of 1844 and health and dietary issues will solve the economic problems. I have a problem with you. Let me tell you why. You want to worship in a free society, but you don't want to get involved in the machinery that delivers the political freedom that you want so much. I mean, it's beautiful to worship as an Adventist in a free country. Question for you: who delivers the free country to you? Who has gone to die on the battlefield for you to have a freedom of worship? Now that the countries are free, there are economic problems, there are political problems, there are social problems. All of a sudden, you want to exclude yourselves to weeks of prayers. Don't get politically involved in anything, because all these things are in the hands of God. If they were in the hands of God, then how come God used political figures who were to die and be incarcerated in prisons to deliver to you the political freedom that you need? I think this is typically a sign of hypocrisy to the highest order, that you want to enjoy freedom, but you don't want to get involved in the things that deliver that freedom. There is rape all around. There's abuse all around. There's economic injustice all around. Should we be sitting around and reading our Sabbath school quarterlies and say the